I propose we go forward with your monsters versus aliens idea thingy.
At DreamWorks Animation, you know, it all starts with a great story and great storytelling. Monsters versus aliens. The promise of just the title alone is exciting and intriguing.
Attention, all aliens! Destroy all monsters!
The innovation of InTrue 3D,
which are authoring tools for our artists and our filmmakers,
it just creates a spectacular opportunity to make the emotions of storytelling even better.
When we first decided to do this movie in 3D, we came up with a lot of new tools and new technology that helps us direct in 3D to a point where we're telling the story a little more subtly with 3D.
The things that attracted me to the project is just pushing it as far as we possibly could.
There's such a insatiable appetite to continue to invent and stay on the leading edge. And our strategic partnerships with HP and Intel have been an essential part of creating the foundation to enable that.
We need monsters.
Hi, I'm benzoate acetylene bicarbonate, or you can call me Bob.
Bob's definitely a more difficult character than a lot of the ones we've done here. And unlike characters we've done in the past, there's some very complicated things that he's able to do.
No, he's a chemically altered ranch-flavored dessert topping that was combined with a genetically altered tomato.
He can have arms come out of him. He can grow, you know, his eye comes out. He can split in two, stretch, bend all different kind of ways. So it was different than all the process.
What are they running away from?
In terms of behavior, I love the kind of motion that Bob can pull off. I think it's really funny to see him eat and then watch as he either digests or regurgitates things.
I love you! I love this man!
I was blown away just seeing it all come together. It's just amazing.
Amazing!
They called me crazy, but I'll show them. I'll show them all.
Monsters vs. Aliens being our first stereo 3D film, we had a number of challenges that we had to overcome. We had to invent pieces of technology that simply didn't exist in the market.
I think one of the biggest challenges to sort of maintaining creativity is to sort of stay in that flow. And for us, the HP XW8600 workstations powered by Intel Xeon processors have made a tremendous difference to really help get stuff back faster than it's ever come back before.
One of the big challenges with making a stereo 3D film is you need a separate image for both the left and right eyes, which effectively meant that the enormous compute power we need to do these films to begin with in a normal 2D non-stereo film, we now had to double that.
HP and Intel, they always want to sort of step up to the challenge. As I sit back and I look back at, you know, what MVA was able to accomplish in terms of using 40 million render hours in roughly the same amount of time that the original Shrek used 5. So they were able to do roughly 8 times the amount of work in the same amount of, you know, wall clock time. It is an incredible feat that we simply couldn't have done without HP and Intel.
It's a shame you won't be around to see what the power of Quantonium can do.
I know how to use it just fine.
This was a huge undertaking for the studio to actually provide us with a suite of tools to be able to do 3D.
Always let her drive the camera.
Okay. We could literally shoot the action, whereas we've always had to rely on moving a camera within the computer. So this gave us cameras that feel like they're adjusting to the performance.
That's amazing.
The San Francisco scenes where Susan gets chased down the streets and then eventually out onto the bridge. All that action that feels like it's being filmed by a camera operator makes you believe, wow, this is not animation anymore, this is real. And that combined with actually perceiving 3D was just mind-blowing.
Let's take this thing down.
In this film, they really got to pull out all the stops and create big visual effects that people are recognizing as, wow, those are great effects.
I got him, you guys!
The Golden Gate Bridge was the biggest sequence that has been produced at the studio here. There were technical challenges in terms of how are we actually going to ensure that it has the weight to convince you that it really is a huge structure that's falling to bits.
And the visual effects were even more complicated because we're banging into the bridge and it's crumbling and there's dust everywhere.
He's trying to kill me! Why is it doing that? Why would it?
That was even more complicated and stuff we've never done before. And then when we finally got through all of that, we were doing all of this in 3D.
I especially loved how you saved all those people on the bridge. It was a nice touch.
I'm so buzzing. I mean, did you see how strong I was? There probably isn't a jar in this world I can't open.
This is our first in true 3D film, which for us really represents the highest end of what's possible in stereo filmmaking. Intel was an essential part of bringing that compute power to enable us to create interactive tools to design the 3D with intention.
It's been an extraordinary transformation to see an industry really almost reinvent itself, going from 2D images to 3D images. In True 3D has raised the bar with Monsters versus Aliens.
When we talk about 3D, the movie experience for people is going to be forever changed.
It's over.
Turn it off.